So, Caleb.
What's up?
We have two trailers to talk about.
More so one.
More so one. But actually, the second one looked kind of good.
Yeah. Honestly, both of them were kind of... I kind of like both of them. I feel better about each movie this time than the first time.
That's the first trailer?
Yeah. The second trailer's made me feel better than I did the first time seeing these two.
Well, let's dive into the first one, which is Dark Phoenix.
Yeah. When you explained it to me earlier, because you saw it earlier, I thought it was going to be even worse. Like, I'm ready to write this movie off. But after seeing this trailer, I feel better about it.
I mean, I'm not against it. It has cool shots. And I think this story will kind of... I don't really know what the story is going to be. My interpretation...
I think what they're going for is that they want you to think that she's trying to kill all of them. I feel like that's going to be like the first half of the movie.
Do you think somebody's controlling her?
The blonde lady. What's her face? I think she's in her head and she's trying to work for her.
Trying to kill all
of them.
And
then I feel like that shot where she's picking up the train... She's rescuing them.
Okay, maybe. Yeah.
Oh, she's rescuing them, but they think that she's trying to kill them.
Maybe you cannot deny it, though.
They're going to do that thing where the audience, like, two people are going after the hero, like two types of villains, the government, whatever, and then the supernatural, Dark Phoenix. And then we're going to get the reveal that she's actually trying to save them or whatever.
But you can't deny that Jennifer Lawrence is going to die.
Oh, yeah. Do you think that's because they actually wanted to write her off because of Jennifer Lawrence or because they don't know how they could fit Mystique into the story?
No, I think Jennifer Lawrence just wanted to be written off.
Do you think she wanted it or the studio wanted nothing to do with her anymore?
In ways, both, because I think as like the community of us viewers knew she was phoning it in. So I feel like it was kind of like a mutual agreement. Like Jennifer Lawrence is like, hey, I don't want to be in these. And Fox is like, oh, good. We don't want you in them either. So that really works out.
I don't know how they're going to kill everyone. That was your earlier thought, that you just think everyone's going to die?
Maybe, because how would you end this movie? Are you going to end it like, and then 3 years down the line, a new X-Men movie come out with a whole new cast? And you're just like, oh, so we're... I don't know. I mean,
how's that going to feel walking out of the theater that everyone's dead? Dark Phoenix is alive, or she kills herself and kills everyone around her.
What if the world just explodes?
She has the power.
I kind of want a movie like that, don't you? The world just explodes and that's the end of the movie.
And then we get an end credit scene of Thanos snapping his finger and that's what happened.
Wow.
All the X-Men died.
That's how it connects. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they were a part of the snapping.
Yeah, the snapping. That needs to... Why is that not a shirt? You know? I remember saying it, what, like 4 minis ago?
Right, the snapping.
Yeah. And just the glove doing the... At post-snap.
Yeah.
You know, like, in the motion.
I love the shot where Fassbender's holding all the guns.
That was cool.
That was a
good
shot.
Dude, his head getting crushed.
How does...
Insinuating that
shirt,
like... How
is he gonna get out of that?
Yeah. Insinuating that she is stronger than him and just being able to crush his helmet on him. That's cool.
Yeah.
And, like, this is Magneto. Maybe not in his prime yet. He's still younger. I feel like his prime is middle to late age, you know?
If we're talking about... the poster, where you have obviously like the good and bad, and the beast is on the bad side, which I think is kind of interesting in the poster.
Maybe it's not so much the evil side. I feel like he's just gonna be darker because his love died. I wanted to point out, do you think Jim Cameron is gonna sue them because two blue light creatures are piloting the space ship thing? He's like, those look like avatars. I think you're ripping off Avatar.
Are they called avatars?
Do you think I know anything about those movies? It came out like 20 years ago.
Seriously,
at this point.
All
I know is you put your hair into a bird and you fly with it.
Yeah. You do some weird things with your hair thing. Little... Okay, I'm not talking about Avatar. I mean, I am going to watch it and I'm probably going to enjoy it.
Right.
And I think it'll be better than Apocalypse, at least.
Oh, yeah. Apocalypse wasn't terrible.
But, like, when you're looking at the four that we... No, sorry, the three that we have right now, it's definitely, in my opinion, the lowest.
This is the fourth one.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting about Days of Future Past.
Oh, that's the best one.
I like First Class.
I think
that's the best one.
First Class is a nice reboot, prequel.
Origin.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I think Days of Future Past blends the two, the original trilogy and
that's what,
the new characters.
That's what
it didn't, but like it made it feel so well. but then they ruined it with Apocalypse Now.
Right.
And then you're just
Apocalypse Now? They did that on purpose.
You're ruining with Apocalypse because you're just like, okay, well, the X-Men never mention Apocalypse in the original trilogy, so...
like that's what happens when you put time travel in your movie.
And I just love the very end of Days of Future Past where, like, Cyclops is alive and he's just a dick again. You're just like, oh my god, they did it! Like,
and they did it!
And of course, like, you have Quicksilver. Amazing scene in that movie.
Right.
And then...
they gotta have another one in this one.
Now, I was watching Jeremy Johns. He pointed out, are they gonna copy Justice League where he is running around Jean, but then she moves her head, kind of like Superman did, to show that she pretty much can do every power.
She can't do that much.
I don't know.
What if this is better than Captain Marvel? Just because?
I really want to hate Captain Marvel. I really want to hate it when it comes out. I'm going to be mad if I come out and be like, dang it, that cat was so cute.
The cat is the reason it saves the movie.
Right.
I'm not even going to be mad.
But there was another trailer that we watched.
Well, hold on. I still got one more thing.
What's that
thing? Jean, Cyclops, and Wolverine are like the big three, right?
Yeah.
Like they were the big three in the originals, right?
Mm-hmm.
So like, obviously no Wolverine, but how are they going to transition to that, you know? Because Jean is still very young, and obviously Cyclops. Like, are they trying to follow any sort of comic canon? Because obviously Dark Phoenix is a big comic for X-Men. So where does that go? You know? How does that end? I assume that's where they're going to follow, you know?
Maybe.
And then kill them off just for sake of convenience?
I don't even know if this is really going to be based on a comic.
Right?
I don't know.
Well, it's Dark Phoenix is like the big comic, so you
but like imagine. I wonder if they're like how much they're pulling from
right
and how much they're just trying to scatter a plot.
Mm-hmm.
But
I assume at this point they don't know what to do, so they're just like, let's just make the comic,
right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm thinking.
And the deal happened after or during shooting? The deal happened early last year, right?
Yeah, it happened in the middle, probably shooting.
Okay. So they didn't know they were already losing the rights after.
No.
So they don't even know that they're going to write it off, you know?
Well, maybe they could have done, like, reshoots.
Right.
Kind of like with New Mutants.
Were there a lot of reshoots with this?
Any maybe. I don't know. I don't remember following any news.
And then what's happened with New Mutants? Nothing's been announced with that?
We'll talk about that.
Wait, we got a trailer, right?
No, we didn't. Like a long time ago.
No, I was thinking something else. I remember seeing a trailer recently with ATJ.
Gotcha.
That was something else. But yes, we saw another movie that dropped today.
Hellboy.
Yeah. With his ripped little self and that dropped 20 minutes ago. Wow.
Yeah, but this will come out.
Whoa. Just dropped at 12:30 at night? That's a very weird time to drop a trailer.
Interesting.
Wow.
We're
recording very late.
But yeah, this, so we talked about it earlier. I don't know where we talked about the first trailer.
What do you mean?
Like a podcast or something, and maybe. we both were laughing.
I think it was because we saw it before one of our movies.
And it just looked really bad.
Yeah.
This is a Red Band trailer, too. Let's emphasize that, okay?
It's very violent.
It's like,
and I'm okay with that.
Like, that gigantic monster just stepping through that. Like, did you see King Kong? Yeah, King Kong Skull Island with that one spider creature. Like, that is what this trailer does. And I'm like, ooh, but it's like bloody. And Caleb and I talked about it before filming. Like, if they go for this rated R,
yeah, if they Logan this and just dive right into it, I think it's gonna be good.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be good.
I feel like they need to screen it to an audience. And then realize a lot of the jokes are bad.
Yeah.
And then cut those, at least the trailer ones. Maybe there's some good jokes in there. Cut out the forced ones that aren't necessary.
This isn't a 90s action movie that has cheesy punchlines. It's
Maybe they're going for that.
Maybe they're going for it.
You saw how well Aquaman worked. I mean, the jokes weren't as bad, but it was still a little campy.
But like, you have a great Jason Momoa who's very charismatic character. I feel like Hellboy doesn't have that charisma.
Oh, true. Yeah. But the actor himself, I can't remember the guy's name. I haven't watched Stranger Things, but I know he's a great actor.
He's a great actor.
So I don't want to.
But I don't know if he's a funny actor. because he's not funny at all in Stranger Things. He's pretty serious.
Right.
So
he's what, like a sheriff or something?
Yeah, he's like a sheriff of Little Town. So I don't think I've seen him in anything else. Mm-hmm. But he looks ripped. Mm-hmm. Unless he's wearing like a little outfit costume thing.
No, I think I remember seeing like a before and after picture. I think he actually beefed up for this.
Gotcha. I do like the music in this one more.
Eh, I was lucky with it.
I like it more
the idea of remixing a song.
Billy Joel's Money Money or whatever.
Right.
Like in the first trailer.
Oh, but they revealed way too much.
That shot. When he's on the dragon, yeah. And like,
unless that happens in the middle of the movie.
If trailers only show us the first like 30 minutes of the movie, which this trailer is not,
right.
Like, I'm totally cool with that. But yeah, like, they're going hard with this crown.
Oh, the fire crown.
And the sword. Like, I wonder if he's going to have that for a good chunk of the movie.
Right. Probably not.
Probably not. I do like seeing little Hellboy, baby. That was fun.
Yeah, that was interesting.
Yeah.
Those Nazi 3D glasses were a joy to look at.
Any more thoughts? This comes out first, and then Dark Phoenix. This comes out in April, and then Dark Phoenix comes out in June.
All right. God, Hellboy, why would you drop it in April? Why? So many things are dropping in April.
I don't know. We had to pump out two podcasts like a week.
Yeah. Well, we'll get to that. Drop it in May. What are you doing?
Right.
That's so dumb.
What's really happening in May?
Anyways, tell us what you think, guys.
Yeah, leave comments below. Until next time, peace.
Bye.